Gallery Summer Residency. If you missed it, you missed out. What you're about to see here is a mixture of canvas, sculpture, and moving picture work that are a conveyance of the need to address the climate crisis with more urgency, passion, and creative approaches. Audio descriptions of the work are available online at tlwvision.au. There's also, just behind this fascinating yes. right here, a little sheets of paper, and you can read those as well. Please direct all inquiries about purchase, hint, hint, to Soulstaff. These beauties need to be out in the world. Please let Soulstaff know if you'd like to purchase one. But there's one that you can't get, someone here already got it. Before I unleash you to explore the work further, it gives me inestimable pleasure to introduce an incredible human being, Caroline Bowditch. Caroline is the Chief Executive Officer, Artistic Director of Arts Access Victoria, and the creative lead of the Alter State Festival. Caroline's enjoyed an acclaimed career in the UK for over 16 years as a performance maker and industry leader, and is a regular consultant on accessibility and inclusive practice across Australia, Europe, the UK, and the world. During her tenure at Arts Access Victoria, Caroline has developed strong partnerships, and her advocacy has resulted in significant reform of funding programs for deaf and disabled artists. Caroline has overseen the development of a new strategic plan at Arts Access Victoria, with a vision of cultural equity for deaf and disabled people, all of them. Caroline's leadership is grounded in delivering on this vision in the years ahead. Please welcome Caroline.
Thank you for that glorious and very generous introduction. It is a privilege to be here with all of you, celebrating you and your amazing work team. We are the purchaser of that fine work behind that, yeah, on there, and it's going to live in our house. Once it's finished, it's world tour with this exhibition. It is a real privilege to be here on these traditional lands. I was born on Yorta land, and my connection to land is really significant. I didn't realise it was until I was overseas. And even though in conversation at the moment about you coming to photograph the land that I grew up on, because I think your eye sensitivity to nature is so highly tuned and in tune, it's just it's wonderful. It's a very special place in my heart and it would be amazing. So I'm very excited. Very much look forward to having your work in our humble abode. where you always just come and visit.
So I'd like to say a few thank yous and then talk about why the Reclamation of Terra is so important with everything going on in the world. Firstly, I would like to give thanks to Pride Foundation Australia for their belief in this project and their generous support. I am an independent artist. I have no money. So any funds, grants that I receive, you, half of the audience here, you all know you're all artists, you understand the thirst. We're all thirsty, so I'm very, very grateful for Pride Foundation Australia to see what my vision is and to grant me a similar way, and yeah, very much. Secondly, I would like to thank Millie and the conveners at ArtStop. I wanted to create my landscape photography and had a vision, but not the means. The conveners have guided me through the entire process. Thirdly, I could not have come this far without the support and belief of Midsummer and their Pathways Mentorship Program. Through this program, I have been mentored by outstanding award-winning photographer Luke David. Under his tutelage, my craft has blossomed. All of these photographs, they were the inkling in my eye. Under his tutelage, like, I have grasped so much more about what I'm experiencing this world, and I am forever grateful. I would also like to thank the galleries who have posted items from this series over the last 12 months. Yes, it's been going for 12 months. From my residency at Yarra Sculpture Gallery to Climate Gallery, and everyone in between. Many thanks to Pim and Ash here at Soul Gallery for having me and for being calm against my chaos. I know I can do a lot, just ask my family. So I really appreciate your time. To my friends and family who are here, who aren't here, you mean the world to me. You have always seen my potential and believed in me, even when I doubted myself, which was a lot. A big thanks for Caroline to come in and speak tonight. I've had the pleasure of hearing you speak at various events, and you always leave me inspired and wanting to do more for the community and just more in the world. Thank you also for being the first person to purchase a painting from the series, number 32, Temporal, from the series, and when it was in the early stages of development. You've worked with so many outstanding artists and are yourself an outstanding artist that I really appreciate your love of my work. Then there is Bayley. You are a gem. You are a chaotic whirlwind of Aquarius creativity. And I am totally here for it. You constantly confuse me with your esoteric turn of phrase, but your poetry is benign. Your words challenge me to think better, feel more, and love harder. Your willingness to share your vulnerability with me is a treasure that I adore. I admire your strengths and your weaknesses. Your friendship is such a gift, and I'm eternally grateful that not only were you able to MC tonight, but that you blessed my life for knowing you. What this series is all about. Why was it so important to me to create the Reclamation of Terra? Please read the lookbook. It has some insights that I'm not going to delve into tonight. And I have also written an artist statement about the series that you can find on my website at tlwvision.au. In the words of Yoko Ono and Anoni, I know I never said to you, but I want to say it to you now. I love you, Earth. I love you now. Also, I will say this. Artists have always been in the forefront of social movements, questioning the status quo. Queer, trans, disabled, black, people of colour. Minority groups whose voices society would try to muffle. We have always been here. We have always led. Artists can be solitary creatures, especially those of us with autism, but know from experience that we are stronger together. In this togetherness, we must include First Nations people. As the original custodians of the land, Indigenous peoples across the world have known for over 65,000 years how to cultivate the land and the seas in unity with the elements. The current logging moratorium in Victoria comes with a warning from the Indigenous community that now is not the time to let nature run feral. We must continue to nurture and feed the land and waters so that we can be literally and metaphorically fed for many more centuries to come. If we unite, we can make our planet sustainable for generations to come. But it is vital that every one of us learns and does the work. I know work is a dirty word. The LGBTQIA+SP community are tired of working against an unjust system of constantly appealing for change and equity. But we must work on fixing the planet, or else what good is fighting for equality if there is no food to eat, nor air to breathe? In working for global justice, we must prioritize a cohesive unit, the reversal of climate destruction. If I get the funding, I plan on having a little clinic where I will look at the cancellation of drag queens across many accounts and runs in real time as a result of increased hate towards minorities, including towards myself as a trans man. I want to stand out and champion the community I call family. There will be poets and singers at this event. All the artists that I love and adore who bring so much to our community. We must unite, we must highlight them. In January, please come to Victorian Artists Society to see this, to see what we are, to celebrate what we are. Follow my website for updates. I have started a blog. It's semi-regular. We're not allowed to say more about the event. I will let you know. For now, I urge each one of you here tonight to act. Act now. But first, buy my artwork and tell your networks about what I am trying to achieve. Because we all need it. We all need this.
Caroline, and to all of you for your patience and attention as we do proper service to this work and the heart and community that has made this event a possibility. We hope you enjoy the evening, and please approach myself, Soul Gallery team, etc. if you need any further support to make your evening accommodating and unforgettable. Please feel free to share your experiences on social media. There are a bunch of ways to follow us. Come ask us, we're always here to share our handles. Welcome. Please enjoy the Reclamation of Terra.